We get asked all the time on how to paint cool lava bases for your miniatures, and with the advent of the Mordant Earth technical paint, it's become even easier than ever. In this video, we're going to show you exactly how to paint those cool lava bases and give you a couple of cheeky tips on how to best get the crackle effect out of your crackle paints. Now, we're going to show you how it works on this here 40mm base. You might notice that there's no model attached to it, and actually it's easier to do your bases separately and then attach them later on, so that's what we're going to do. Now, the first thing we're going to do is to paint that fiery effect underneath the crackle. So first of all, we're going to base coat our base with Mephiston Red, and for this we're going to be using our large base brush, so let's get to it. Now, here we go, we're just going to take a little bit of Mephiston Red from the pot, just going to make sure there's not too much paint on the brush, and then straight onto the model, well, the base in this situation, we're just going to apply it all over the base nice and evenly, making sure we get a nice even coat all over the base. And there we go, we have a nice solid Mephiston Red colour on top of our base, ready for the next stage. And the next stage is to start adding some more of the fiery colours in, and we're going to stipple on a couple of oranges. First of all, Troll Slayer Orange, and then secondly, Fire Dragon Bright. So for this, we're using our small dry brush. I'm going to take a little bit of Troll Slayer Orange out of the pot here, and then we're going to dry brush it off onto the piece of tissue paper we have here until there's almost nothing left on the brush. Then onto the base, we're going to apply it on in an unusual way. We're stippling here. This is like a stabbing motion, like so. And we're applying it in random patches all over the top of the base. For the next stage, we're doing the same again, this time with Fire Dragon Bright. Again, we're applying random patches all over the base with this stippling effect. So there we go, our random stipple effect is complete on top of the base, and it's time now for the next stage. Now, normally we'd suggest that you apply the Mordant Earth over the top of this and you allow it to dry naturally and get a really good crackle effect. But we're actually going to give you a couple of cheeky tips to get an even better crackle effect on your crackle paints. Now, first of all, we're going to apply a layer of Art Coat Gloss Varnish over the top of what we've just applied. The reason for this is that will give the crackle paint something extra to grip onto and you'll get even bigger cracks. So for this, I'm grabbing my large base brush again and let's get onto it. Let's take our Art Coat Gloss Varnish out of the pot like this. We actually want quite a thick coat, so I'm going to leave quite a lot on the brush. And then onto the base, just going to apply it nice and liberally all over the top like so. And there we go, the Art Coat Gloss Varnish has been applied to our base. It's given a shiny effect, but don't worry, by the time this technique is over, that will have gone. So now it's the moment of truth. We're going to be applying our Mordant Earth crackle paint on top of the base. Now the first top tip I can give you here is to always shake the pot first. This way the paint will be nice and shook up and you'll get better cracks as a result of it. Once you've given it a good shake, it's time to start applying it to our base. And for this we're using our large base brush. And the reason for this is we actually want quite a lot of paint, because the thicker the paint on the base, the bigger the cracks will be. So here we go. I've got a nice thick amount of Mordant Earth. I'm just going to start applying it onto our base like so. Now, another top tip here is you might be tempted to sort of like do it in one direction like this and sort of paint like this, but actually you don't want to do that. You want to be applying it in different areas like so, because you don't want to have streaks on it when it dries. So there we go. Nice and thick amount here. I'm just going to be going and covering the entire base with the Mordant Earth. So there we go, we've applied a nice thick coat of Mordant Earth onto our base, and normally we'd leave that to dry for a couple of hours to get a good crackle effect. But actually it's time for another one of our cheeky tips, because we're going to use a hairdryer here to speed up the drying process. Not only will this make it quicker, but the heat will actually make the cracks bigger as well. So here we go, we've got a normal hairdryer here. I'm just going to take our base and just turn it onto a low setting. Now we're going to use a low setting to make sure we're not melting the base, and also use short bursts to make sure we're not distorting it as well. Here we go. So there we go, we've heated the Mordant Earth with our hairdryer and it's crackled away, giving this really cool volcanic effect. But there's one more thing we're going to do onto our base, and that's to apply a layer of Larmian Medium over the top of the crackle paint. This will do two things. Firstly, it will help matte down any of the gloss varnish still showing through, and second of all, it will help seal the crackle paint to the base, making it much more hardy for gaming. For this, we're going to be using our medium shade brush. I'm going to take a little bit of the Larmian Medium out of the pot. I'm just going to put a bit onto the palette here to make sure we're not overloading our brush. And then very carefully, onto the base, we're just going to apply it very gently all over the base. Don't press down too hard here, because you don't want to dislodge the crackle bits from the base. Allow about 10 minutes for it to fully dry, and once it has, we're going to paint the rim of the base with a Baden Black. And there we go, with the Larmian Medium dry and the base rim painted a Baden Black, that's our lava base complete and ready for its miniature. So that's how you paint lava bases using the Mordant Earth technical paint. Few things to remember here. First of all, apply a layer of Ardcoat Gloss Varnish over the stippling effect to give the Mordant Earth something to grip onto. Then, when you're applying the Mordant Earth, apply it in thick layers, and also make sure you're not applying it in straight lines. Then finally, if you have one, use a hairdryer to speed up the drying process. It'll also help you give those really big cracks on your lava base. Hope you found the video useful. Happy painting.